It takes time in the morning for me to become George. Time to adjust to what is expected of George and how he is to behave. By the time I've dressed and put the final layer of polish on the now slightly stiff but quite perfect George, I know fully what part I'm supposed to play.
I think all of us really look for those performances that define an actor, where we can just kick back and watch the talent soar. A Single Man is that film for Colin Firth.
Looking in the mirror, staring back at me, isn't so much a face as the expression of a predicament.
Just get through the goddamn day.
Here he is, George, middle-aged, still British, but he has been transplanted to L.A., where he's been a college professor for years. He's also gay, and it's the 1960s, where being open about it was not commonplace, and so no one really knows how much he's suffering over the accidental death of his longtime love. In fact, he has really decided that life is not worth it if Jim is not there, and this is going to be his last day. And that's where the film spends its time.
Having a real relationship and kids.
I had Jim.
No, I mean a real relationship. Joe, let's be honest. What you and Jim had together was wonderful, but wasn't it really just a substitute for something else?
Now, that might sound like an incredibly, unrelentingly sad story, but there is so much humor and warmth in this as George moves through that final day. In the hands of fashion designer Tom Forbes, who is making a very impressive directing debut here, the film is just filled with such quiet, saturated beauty that it's mesmerizing. It can feel like one of those gorgeous magazine spreads that you cannot take your eyes off of. And there are so many grace notes in Colin Firth's performance. Like anybody who's lost somebody that they love, he's buffeted by waves of emotion and memories, some of them good and some of them not. But every one of them, he absolutely plays with his heart. It's a performance to savor. This is Betsy Sharkey with the Los Angeles Times.